selfish. Remain generous. I will remain generous. Anyway, some of your greatest plans or pains, sorry, greatest pain will come from those you gave the most pleasure. Some of your greatest disappointments will come from those you gave your best appointments. Some of the worst things you hear about yourself may come from those you speak the best of. Not everyone in your ship is peddling in the direction of your dream destination. Discernment is key. Loving people sometimes means feeling used by them. If you fail for the temptation to take an eye for an eye, you will be blinded to the bounties God has in store. Sometimes doing the right thing ends up making you look like a fool. Tough as it seems, any evil done against you can become a seed for your promotion. It depends on your response. I'd rather appear foolish now and see the wisdom of God unfold than appear wise now and turn out to be a fool later. Promotion doesn't come by fighting for your rights, but by being faithful in doing what is right. Those who will enjoy true promotion must be willing to forgive freely, forgive quickly, and forgive wholly.
Yes.
Okay. I'm a journalist. And most of you, you're going to be journalists.
Yes.
Those who will relish true promotion must be willing to save many for free. Read with caution sometimes. To see what God can do, you have to be willing to stop what you can do. Without God's sign off, your biggest step can turn out to be your biggest mistake. Pain has a higher potential to toughen you up than pleasure does. Problems are easier to solve than in people. Many people will celebrate you only as long as your advancement doesn't exceed their expectations of you. Some people get close enough to you just to find something bad about you to broadcast to the world. Some people are quiet when you are succeeding, but quick to point out your failures. Some people are in your life for a reason. Some people in your life would prefer to see you in prison. Love your enemies, pray for them, but despitefully use you. That hasn't changed. Hating those who hate you makes them your leaders, since you are following their footsteps. Rather than react to the situation, respond to your revelation. When people show you who they really are, show them who God is. Good always do them good. We don't do people what they have done to us. We do to them what God's done to us. We love them. Believe the best, even when you are going through the worst. Keeping a grudge is like keeping garbage you can't use. Yet it's taking up space and no one is paying your rent. Malice is a demonstration of your faith in the pain caused to you in the past. It keeps you stuck. Rather than perpetuate pain, promote peace, stir up joy, and spread love. They hate you, don't hold it against them. Hold them up in prayer. Some people may think this post is targeted at them. No, everyone alive will need one of the points at some point. Choose one another. Okay. How you respond to a situation can be more important than the situation. Your ability to overlook an offense determines the degree of dominion you will exercise over many other things. Wisdom will help you solve problems. A large heart will help you accommodate people. You need both. when all is said and done, let the love of God in your heart pour through your daily walk. Peace to you. Jesus never lowered his standards for anyone. Neither should we, should you. My brother. Ndomuna mati wangu kutanga. And then, I was just thinking, for most of you here, who are the first years? Can I have some hands? Or second year, first years to start with. Okay. Okay. Second years and third years. So much for me to find a way for a moment and before you school. Who are the master's students here? Okay. All right. They often say leadership is about overcoming fear. Fearless people are true leaders. Are we together? And why do I say that? I say this because if it's the media studies you're carrying out, one of you is going to be an editor. One day I spoke about Lavimo, and he has been an editor before. Some of you have been to newspapers and work there, and part-time or attachment or whatever. You have a responsibility. When you have a responsibility, it's how you carry it all out. I want to say that as a human being, you need to be always ready for challenges. I became Zifa president. I partook to challenging for that position, and I got it. And once there, what have I done about it? Are we together? Ndakaiti ndakasvika kuzifa kune chikwereti chihombe, ndakasvika kune mashandi hobo, ndakasvika kubhora ndisingatambi nemushe, ndakasvika, you know, kune problems zvokuti anyone who would have been in that position, I don't know what they would have done, but here is the miracle that happened. Zifa is operating normally. Zifa up to date, since I took office, and Owemun Mari, that's juxtaposed to my colleagues who were in office. How long was Kat Bedube in office for? It was in 5 years. Right. In 5 years, and I've been 2 years, in 5 years he had a debt of $7 million. Debt. And people were not paid for nearly 2 years when I got there, right? We can discharge our responsibilities. And I can tell you, he is one of them here. He's the chief media officer. And he's well paid. He's never missed his pay because very, very serious about it. And there were people who were used to causing problems for football. You know what happens? My office, my name is Shanda Mayor. My name is Negative Investments. Once Mugatanga with the chaos, you wish I could pay, it also means that when my family is here, I say, when people there who are employed there, we have children going to school and other responsibilities. That means that just we doesn't. So there has to be order so that you can take care of your other responsibilities. And that is exactly the thing that I sorted. And today we're proud of an administration, functional, discharging of its mandate, and Borel Tangwa and Bungo Famba. In one data president, as you probably have known so far, I then became a COSAFA president. That is 14 countries that report to me. I have a head office in South Africa. The head office is for SAFA. The boss is me. We have a secretary general. She's white. She reports to me. She has an administration there that reports to me. I'm the guy that calls the shots, okay? So immediately becoming the COSAFA president, I had known, not because of how long I was in football for, in football administration, but I had known that we had a problem. The guy who was the CAF president, like a 54-country boss, in a 14-year, 54-country boss, he was not interested to hear Munwandora English, and I know who promoter or who know down part of Africa. Who would say, who know now my opportunities? I from West Africa. So these things I knew. At some point in 2000, Takambun's Dapua Afcon, which is a prime, you know, football extravagance. But what happened? Why Tura? I want to go to Tura. So even I said to myself, when I came in, I'm 29 years come on. I'm which go election. So I'm saying, so in those Zamaku Bumurita, I'll read about the ego at the back of my speech towards the end. I operate like an ego. I see the situation. I read the mistakes. I'm not quick to respond, but when I'm going to do papa, I'm going to cloud. You are on a cash.